Welcome back to Pick Me Up, Scotty. And I'm Scotty. And today we're here in the beautiful... Well, I wouldn't say beautiful. I can't really see anything. But we're in Shanghai, China. And yes, I had time to build this. So let's go review it, shall we? Yeah, so that belongs to this set here. And we're going to do it right here in the hotel room. So here we go. So I told you guys I'm traveling and we're here in Shanghai and it's a little bit more ghetto, the setup, I know. I gotta give a shout out to Nikon Hong Kong for actually really reaching out. I'm using their camera. This is the D7500. I'll show you guys this picture how I'm doing it. And no excuses, man. This is slightly more affordable. The lens is not too expensive. I wanted to keep things very light and compact. So if you guys are trying to do your own channel, brick channel, or whatever in the future, if you have questions about filmmaking, there's no excuse, you can use whatever is available to you, and even if it's cheap, go out and get it and just shoot it. That's the most important thing. So the reason we're in Shanghai right now is because of this guy. This is my dad. My dad's on tour right now. He's a singer from Hong Kong, and we've been touring with him pretty much his whole life, since I was born. And I'm still touring with him. And I do sing for him, but only sing for him. Other than that, I do production, and we're doing this. So, no excuses, I'm doing this for you guys. So without further ado, let's just jump right into it. Let's not waste any time, because I'm doing it. Yes, I can actually film for you guys. So here we go. Rick D, this one's for you. This is Xingbo's Across the Battlefield. XB06018, 1,049 pieces. So what you're seeing is actually the first official military build for me. Yeah, chickens do not count. And it comes with what you see right here. And let's just start with the big boy first. We're gonna start with this tank. And Rick D, you were asking about like how the thing works. I'm not a tank, guys, I don't know. First thing I can tell you though is, this is really awesome. Like, it doesn't feel so steady. That's what I'm saying like about some other themes like Star Wars. They feel kind of incomplete. But when I see the tank here and I see the design of the tiles and the way that it has this like kind of like a glossy look to it, this feels more like a complete build to me. That's my opinion, that's what I think. But, you know, you never know. I'll probably get into those themes later. But for now, here it is. This is a bad boy looking tank. Ooh, look at the details on this thing. It's actually pretty sweet. However, oh man, when I was looking at the manual and I saw rubber bands and I saw hundreds of little pieces, I'm like, oh, this is going to be quite a challenge. And it actually was, especially down here by the wheels. It feels like it really wants to fly off. But once you put it all together, it's really nice and tight and snug. But it doesn't really roll that great. I don't even think it really rolled at all. But if you like lift it up and you kind of pull on the track, there's tension there. And you can see a couple of tires don't really reach the track. That's because with the rubber bands, the plastic bands that they have in there, there's two different sizes and they're off by like 0.1. Like one's like 1.6, one's 1.7. I can't tell the difference. Maybe I use the wrong rubbers in different areas. But they do like rotate if you pull on it. And the wheels are actually really loose. It's just the ends are kind of tight. So if you're going to put it on like any kind of flooring, it's even if you apply pressure from it, it's probably not going to really move. You know, I don't know how important it is for you guys. Other than that, if you just like display it around, this thing is pretty dope. Look at that. Like sturdy and it's got a lot of details. So let's just take a look at this as a whole. We're going to look here from the sides first. Okay, so we're looking at the sides here. The side is actually really cool. I like how they put it all together. You got tools there along the top part and on the side here and a little chain. And this is a printed shark logo on the tile. I really like the tiling. I like that glossy. It's like, I don't know how to say it. It's like rusty kind of looking thing. The only thing that you have to kind of be careful of is some of the light gray looks like dark gray. I think it's the lighting. And the lighting in here is not really that great. So especially if I was working on this at night, I'm like, oh, I mixed the colors up. And some of them just kind of blend together. Some of them look darker than others, but they're actually the same color. I do like the wheels on the bottom. Mind you, those are actually really cool. They are bouncy. They have suspension there. But like I said, some of them are higher than others. Not sure if that's my problem. It's my first build. Maybe I screwed something up there. And the ends are a little bit tight where the track moves. But it all holds into place, which is really nice. Now, on the opposite side, it's actually almost exactly the same, but they have a different printing on the back here of the tile, which is really, really cool. And they have like these little pipings here. Those were a little bit tricky to get in. They don't quite fit in there. I'm trying to fix it right now. We have more tools along the top here. I gotta admit, that's actually pretty cool. I really do like that. Here on the front, you got the headlights. And you got those flaps. You can actually see the engine from the inside. I like that. It's really cool. The whole thing can open up. Look at that. Look at all the piping in there. Yeah, they fit pretty snug. A couple pieces might pop out on you, but it's easy to fix. Not too difficult. The back here has a little door that opens up. You can see inside there. And then, of course, we got the gunner here along the top. He's actually pretty dope. It kind of swivels left to right, not all the way. But if we take the minifigure out, we can close this lid. It's all closed there. You got this little firing machine gun thingy. Probably can't. I wish I had a slow-mo camera here. But check this out. See if I can fire it at you guys. Pew! Ha! Right on the lens. Got binoculars here. A little radar thing. And the guns here. Solid, man. Like, it's not going to go anywhere. This part does come off nicely. It's a modular tank. Now we can switch that piece with another piece. And you finally got here the like control panel thing. There is this piece here that doesn't really fit too tight. It will pop everything off. So I just keep it loose there. It's easier actually that way. So you can just take it right off. And on the inside, you got a control panel. I really dig that. I think that's actually pretty cool, man. Now it's really difficult to get on the back side on the inside, but they have like a telephone. They have printed tiles here with like some screens on it. You got radar. Got something that looks like another Windows 95 computer. Oh, I wish they had like better printing on that. Maybe I'll switch it around. And otherwise, there you go. That's the tank. I think the tank is pretty sweet, pretty well done. I had no problems with it. I like the size. The size is pretty good. I'm not quite sure where I'm gonna put this in my city block, but I guess I have to make a battlefield now, just for you guys. Let's move on to the next set that comes along with it. Yeah, we got the gunner. Look at that. Yeah, it rotates. This looks like something straight out of Star Wars. It looks pretty cool. I like it. No idea what it's really called. And of course, you got two more missiles here. We're going to fire it at you guys. And 3, 2, 1. Oh, one shot off. Oh, that was a failed one. You have failed me. Nice solid piece of gear. I guess this is going to be a new addiction. And finally, we got all the minifigures. Let's line them all up. Should I name them? Yeah, let's name them. You know what? I'm gonna start repeating names. I'm just gonna repeat whoever was the first few people to comment on the last few videos in that particular order. So here we go. If your name gets repeated, congratulations. So the tank driver here with the binoculars is Home Abroad 68. Yeah, the universe is back in order. And these guys are here to protect me and make sure mistakes never happen again. The guy in the gunner is Tyler. Tyler, once again, great support. Thank you so much. Glad you really like the videos. And, you know, are you sure you want to man this gun? And then we've got Anonymous MC with the pistol there. You know, the prints so far on all these guys, they look fantastic. I think they look great. I love the vest and everything. They're actually pretty cool. Dang. Man, Thingbo's got the military thing down, I think. Finally, we got Rick D. There you are again. You're the main general, I guess, with your gun. Way to go out there. This is going to be known as the Rick D Battlefield because you suggested I try it and review this. So here it is for you. So there guys go. This is Across the Battlefield from Zingbo, part of their series. There's tons of these guys. We're just going to call this the Rick D Battlefield. Rick D, thank you for suggesting this. I think it's actually pretty cool. I hope you get an idea of what the tank is like and maybe it's suitable for you. Maybe it's not. Who knows? So thanks a lot for supporting the channel. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. And I'll catch you guys later. Until then, brick me out! If you're ever interested, in that stuff, I have to first give a So ghetto with this camera. The camera doesn't have a flip, so it's tricky to film myself. I'm using my iPad to record the screen from the camera so I can just see the iPad framing on there. So I hope I'm in focus. This is as natural as we can get. If you're still watching this, we're in the hotel room. You want to take a look around? Bonus video. Bonus outtake, why not? You guys can see what my room looks like. Pretty pimped. Pretty fly. Look at that. Here's the laptop, this is where I've been editing from. And hard drive from D-Technology, got a shout out to them, thank you D-Tech. I built this one. This is from the LEGO Creator Series. This is the skate park. It's actually pretty cool, I like it. I like the rock climbing, and you know what, I'll talk about that another day. Let's look around, shall we? I got my food here, chicken rice. I gotta eat, and then I gotta go perform. And I'm building this. You guys know what that is? You take a wild guess. This is the bedroom. I don't know if I have a good view out there or not. I think it's part of the... I'm not sure what city this is. Like, well, the view outside... Let me see if I can let you guys see the view. I don't have an ND filter on here. But here's the view outside my window. We're somewhere in Shanghai. No idea where. There's a lovely bathroom. Dude, check out this bathroom. It's pretty rad. Would you like to join me in the shower? Oh, it's all wet right here. There's the shower. I can't see much of it. So we're taking a bath here. You can look at your lovely girlfriend, boyfriend, wife, husband there. Yeah, so that's your bedroom, guys. Whee! It's kind of hot, man. It's really hot out here. I can't stand the heat. Anyway, time to eat. I gotta go do the concert. I'll do some insert shots for the Battlefield guys, and I'm gonna edit this video. All right, later. You know, I just realized Deer's not here, so I kinda have to do this on my own. So, don't forget to subscribe on my face. See my hands here? Subscribe on my face here. Yeah, right there. Watch a video you may not have seen here, and possibly another one you may not have seen over here. All right, you guys, until next time, I shall catch you later. See ya. Bye.